Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Fidau bin Muhammad Yusuf from group 80221B. Today I want to present chapter 6 about momentum and impact.
On this chapter, firstly we must know what is momentum. Momentum is measure of strength and measure how difficult it is to stop the object. Momentum in simply mean is mass in motion. The formula for momentum is P is equal to mass times velocity. So momentum depends on mass and velocity of object. The momentum equation can be simplified by substitute the word for symbol P equal mv. When P is momentum, m is mass in kilogram, v is velocity in meter per second. So, an object that is at rest or not moving has zero momentum because velocity is zero. So, it means momentum is zero. In order to object have momentum, it must be moving. A slow moving of larger objects have larger momentum because its mass is more, the momentum is also more. A fast moving or small object have a larger momentum because its velocity is more and momentum is also more. For example, if the football ball and bowling ball have a same velocity, the bowling ball have a greater momentum because it is more mass than football ball. Momentum is a vector quantity. This means it has both of magnitude and direction. The velocity also vector quantity because it has both of this component. The direction of the momentum is the same as the direction of the velocity vector. But how is momentum related to the impact? When a force at an object for a short amount of time, impact is measure how much the force change the momentum of object. For the impact momentum theorem, the definition is the impact of the force F acting on a particle equal to the change in the momentum of the particle. Formula for the impact. Impact is equal to the force multiplied by time. Or in the symbol representation, impact is equal to F multiplied by time delta T. It measures how much the momentum change. The alternative formula for the impact is impact equal to the change in momentum. There is delta P vector, the formula related impact to the change in the momentum of the object. Impact have two different units, either kilogram meter per second, kg meter per second, or newton times second, ns. Next, must know about collision. Collision is represented an event during which two particles come close to each other and attract by means of force. In any collision, the total linear momentum is conserved. In collision, the kinetic energy after the collision is generally less than that before collision in two ways. It can be converted into heat because of radiation. It is spent in creating permanent dislocation or damage, as in automobile collision. Collision can divided by two, elastic collision and inelastic collision. For elastic collision, where the object involves remain separate after the collision is occurred. With elastic collision, the total kinetic energy and momentum are conserved, as well as the total momentum of the system. So, the object will bounce off one other with no energy loss as the result of collision. There are many examples of elastic collision, like when a soccer player kicks a ball. seeing the player foot and the ball remain completely separate after the collision. For inelastic collision, when two objects collide, after which they move together as one mass. Example for elastic collision, like a car crash, the total momentum is conserved, but total kinetic energy is not conserved. Much of kinetic energy is conserved into heat or sound energy, which is we hear as the sound of the car crash. On this chapter, I design a simple experiment for momentum and impact by drop it on the floor. The objective on the experiment is to determine relationship between impact and time of collision. The material that need in this experiment is 8 spam and measuring tape. For our procedure in experiment 1, firstly is measure 1.6 meter height from the floor and drop the 8 on the floor at height and record the result. For procedure in experiment 2, put the span on the floor and drop the 8 at the same height in experiment 1 and record the result. For a result in experiment 1, the 8 is crashed because the impact time between the floor and the 8 is short, which means that the force which is impact divided by time become larger enough to create the 8. For a result in experiment 2, the A is not cracked. The A is still okay because the span increased the collision time, and as a result, the force impact was reduced. Hypothesis in the experiment is when the impact time is increased, the force of impact is decreased. In conclusion, impact equals force multiplied by time, and force equal to impact divided by time. In order to stop momentum or reduce force of impact that met severe damage during a collision, the time during the collision must be increased by using safety object.
That's all from me. Thank you for watching this video.